Hey guys, G-Wizard here, and welcome to Free Factory 37. It's been close to a year, if not over a year, since I last tackled these free-to-play stinkers. There just aren't too many of them that drew my ire. That, and I've been dabbling into new games, flashcards, systems, and the like. However, Shell Trandabara brought a few of these games to my attention, and then some. So, to make up for the extended hiatus, again, I'm gonna pick off 8 more terrible excuses of games. There should be a word to describe these. In fact, I think there is. Lames. We're gonna start with Android first. Usually I start with iPhone games, but I found something on there that did not disappoint in terms of rock-bottom quality. Let's pick apart the first game on the list, the first lame. And here it is, our first Android game for today, Zookiemon. Yeah, you remember that one game I showed where it was like MXC combined with Pokemon that does not like ad blockers? Yeah, same creator made this one, Zookiemon. Okay, I'm playing as a Nickelodeon Splat guy, the one they showed in that old 90s animation. It can move around and okay, fight chicks. Okay. What is this? Oh, Pokemon Quest. Let's turn on the music. It's a little quiet. There's no volume control, so just walk in here to unlock a new area. Oh wow, we can fight a dog. Doesn't this go against the food chain or something? Tame. Oh cool, I got a dog. So that's how you tame dogs. You throw a chick against it and hope it's stronger. Yeah, I'm sure that'll play out well in real life. So I gotta heal and try to tame another one. Yeah, the gameplay is so riveting. I don't even know why game developers want to rip off a game as lame as Pokemon Quest. Oh my god. They still kept the tap to win mechanic, where you just tap 10 million fingers on the screen and just win. Look at this. This shouldn't even be possible. So not only do they rip off Pokemon Quest, they have you effortlessly tap the screen 10 million times without restrictions and win. Oh, we got a treasure chest. Extra bonus. Oh, 700 coins. Oh, god damn it. They want you to watch an ad for it. Yeah, no. Bite me. I'm not falling for that ad shit. Evolve. What does it evolve into? Is it gonna evolve into a werewolf? Nope. Evolves into a Siberian husky. No! What? No! We're starting already. Throws up a little pop-up. Just as a replacement for ads. No, I don't want to be notified whenever I hatch an egg. If I want to hatch an egg, I'll just play real Pokemon game. Oh no, my chick died. That's okay. I'll just tame this raccoon spelled incorrectly. These developers don't know what a dictionary is. I can only take a game like this for so long. I don't want to play as a Nickelodeon Splat playing Pokemon Quest. That game is terrible, and this game is also. At least it doesn't freeze the game when you use an ad blocker this time. That's only a minor step above the last one I played from this creator. But it's still garbage. So we're gonna move on now. I may or may not be on soda while doing these. So let me just clear my notifications, and then we're gonna move on to the next game on the list, Tetris Story. Inadvertently, this was not on the Play Store, so I had to download it from the internet. Yeah, I highly doubt this was licensed by the Tetris company. Are they even aware of this? And... oh, yeah. This character design right here takes more than a little inspiration from a Nintendo Switch game called Ninjala. You might have heard of it. So, make a Tetris, yeah. So yeah, this is a Tetris game structured like a Match 3 game. And oh look, they put down bonus pieces to help you out. It's like the game is holding your hand in more ways than one. I don't even know what else to say here. At least the control's better than Paya Paya. But when you're being compared to Paya Paya, when that's a low bar to begin with, you're clearly doing everything wrong with this sort of game. Yeah, you gotta clear the paw prints. Oh wow, totally not a ripoff of another mode from another Tetris game. No, this is all original. This is all original, Your Honor. Yeah, just drop it here. Makes you wonder why a game like this was made without any sort of controller support. But why would you need it when the game is ass to begin with? Yeah. I'm not playing this anymore. In fact, one of the only good things I could say about the game is that it has no 3-star system. Other than that, no, don't fall for this. Don't fall for this bootleg nonsense. Not just because of the character designs, but just because you could play Puyo Puyo Tetris 1 and 2, and maybe Tetris Effect Connected, if you have a Nintendo Switch, or maybe one of those Steam Decks. Bottom line, there are much better ways to play Tetris on the go, but this is not one of them. Alright. It's time to move on to the next game before I start ranting for 10 minutes about rip-offs of Tetris. Now we move on to the next game, which is played in the landscape orientation. It's Super Mattino. The amount of Mario rip-offs on these stores is very countless. Mattino Adventure. Nice rainbow loading bar. What is that music? Oh my god, what is that? What is that? What is Mattino? Christ almighty. Yeah, I don't even. Let's just play. Let's just play. Let's go to World 1, sure. And Level 1. To fight not Bowser. Now, believe it or not, this game actually has controller support. Unfortunately, it's very broken. You press up to jump. B apparently pauses. Okay, let's try the... What? No! The Y button brings up the keyboard! And I can't back out of it! So now I have to tap the middle button, and then go back. Just to go back to the game. I can't do anything with the... I thought the Y button was to, like, throw a fireball or something, but no. It's broken. Touch... Yes, I know. Yeah. Yeah. The controls are really bad. If you're gonna implement controller support, at least you check it through before... Actually... Oh my god. I can't take this. I can't... If this controller support is so broken, I'd rather touch the screen to control Mattino. And that's something I thought I'd never say. Every time you shoot bullet, your money... When they're shooting fireballs in Super Mario Brothers, take your money! Like, hell. Yeah. And they also rip the sound effects from Mario. You can't have a rip-off without ripping off the sound effects. This rip-off is just so splendidly horrible in so many ways. What is this invincibility music? It doesn't sound like invincibility. Alright, touch the button. Alright. Whatever. It's just... Oh, no transition, it just pops you in instantly. Alright. Let's just go in the pipe. Where do we wind up? Oh, that's it. Just collect the stars. On the flagpole. Oh, I got 7,000 points for finishing. Oh, as soon as I talk about the last game not having a 3-star system, this one does. On top of the horrible controller support. Get this out of my face! This doesn't need to exist. And neither do any of the other bootleg Mario ripoffs on this store. I've had enough. I'm starting to get pissed. Thankfully, we reached the last game on the Android list. The Witch Rebirth. And thankfully, this one was on the Play Store. Let's just tap that. The Witch Rebirth. Uh-oh. Why are we going there? Why do they gotta rip off Bayonetta? Yeah, let's change servers. Because I tested this game earlier, so let's go ahead and start. Is that cut off? Oh god, yep, that's not Bayonetta. Ugh. Alright, so other than Bayonetta here, we got Pugilist, which is not Chun-Li with gauntlets. And the male version is coming soon. Oh, a knight. It's not Dante. A mage. Oh, nice creepy smile. An archer. I don't even know who this is either. And we also got General, who is not Guan Yu from Dynasty Warriors. His entrance also makes the performance drop a bit. But, yeah, I guess I'm gonna go with Bayonetta. You actually have multiple styles here, which is surprising for a game like this, but that background is not. Yeah, you could twist it around, but I'm gonna go with Bayonetta. Alright, let me try to type something here. Let's see if the game will accept it. Alright, Bayonetta. Oh, whoa, that's already in use! I know, I'm gonna try another one, though. Let's try Cereza. No! Cereza. There we go. Oh, it actually went through! Alright, let's let it load here, and... Is it me, or is the voice quieter than expected? Oh, it turned up a little bit. There we go. Where am I? Is this Dream? The Goddess of Origin. Yeah. Tipadu? Yeah. They have equipable weapons. It's an MOBA, I think. Actually, no. It's like one of those games. It kind of reminds you of that Mario ripoff I played. Oh, it auto-battles? It's selected by default? Cool, I don't have to do anything. I don't even have to play the game. I could just sit here and explain why these kind of games plaguing the Play Store are not justified. Yeah, oh wow, a fearful boss. Finally got rid of that giant guy. You didn't even have to do anything. You could just jump and do some cool moves, but you could play it on auto. Look at that. You can auto battle. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. This kind of stuff is why this shouldn't be in a game like this, because it takes away the play aspect of the gameplay. Miles. It's not Miles. That's not the Miles I know. Alright. Yeah, it also controls where you're going in the story. Which, why? Again, it takes away from the game aspect of it. Yeah. Oh, wow. Look at that demon warrior. He looks so fearsome. Actually, the graphics as a whole don't look bad for a game like this. I did have to downgrade the graphics a little just to keep performance consistent. It's on the medium setting, if you're curious. And again, you don't gotta do anything. Just sit, hit auto, and I don't think I lost any health from that, did I? But yeah. You got equipment. You go through the story. There's no option to skip these scenes. So, yeah, even more tedious. And while you're playing, you have all these pop-ups in your face. Like, this UI is the worst I've seen in any game ever. And during a cutscene, you still move, which I don't believe that's how it should work. There are too many things wrong with this game. The auto feature is just one of these. The terrible UI that pops up in your face, that's another one. And, yeah. I see no reason why this game should exist. The fact that Platinum Games didn't go after this one yet, well, It shouldn't be surprising. These companies don't go after bootleg mobile games, but instead fan projects that have potential. These don't have potential. They're just... Well, I can't find another word that means the same as stupid. I'm getting dumber just by playing this. These cutscenes go for way too long. There's no skip button, you just take it. One cup, done. Yeah, I'd rather go get another cup of soda than play this anymore. Yeah. I don't know how much I could keep going, the game does it for me. I bet I could do an entire playthrough of this game, recording, and I wouldn't have to do a single damn thing. It's really tough. Yeah, I would say it isn't. The Witch Rebirth is boring, annoying, obnoxious. The whole game is just a solitary auto button. The character designs are just the cherry on top. I would suggest not playing this inadvertently. So, before I get even more bored, let's move on to the iPhone games. Trust me, it's gonna be a lot more exciting than the crap we just saw a few minutes ago. Here we are at the second half of the 8 games. On iPhone, we're gonna start with Jewel Party. Ugh. You can guess which this is. And there's a reason I stayed away from these for a while. Yep, another game that rips character designs from Ninjala. And yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a fresh save. Turn it down a little, and start at the first level. Yep. It's match 3. Who would have guessed? Thankfully, you can skip these tutorial levels. Which is more than what I could say for the other match 3 games I played. And oh wow, you have to face some Wild West girl. The dialogue in this is just... robotic. Oh wow, we can actually call ourselves something. Let's call ourselves Ninjala. That joke might have been obvious, but it's... Wait, you could skip that? That was a tutorial level? Ah. Okay, I wonder what the next level will be. Alright, let's play. Let's pick this football-playing girl. It's the only one we can play at the moment. Being great is not only about the scoreboard. It's a good life lesson, though. Oh, this is player versus player. Hans? Oh god, I'm sorry you have to be on this show just playing this trash.
Your turn.
I highly doubt this is a real player, though. Or they could have done like the Dempamen and just do computer players that can be easily exploited by cheats and hacks. But yeah, this is a match 3 player versus player game. It's barely different from what I've played in the past, and it's just as monotonous. Then let me go ahead and match up these triangles here. The game might give you advice, but you could still do your own thing. You share the same board. Watch, he's gonna match the 4, yep. And you get an extra move by matching 4. It's nothing in the settings, though. They get a free shuffle. And I'm assuming that hammer is... Yeah, you can destroy a piece. I'm pretty sure that's what it's for.
Your turn.
Now, I'm not sure if this is a bot. It took a bit of time processing that move. Oh, oops. Go down here. And, yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna lose, but I don't care. I'm gonna destroy it with a hammer. Yeah. Smash 10 million hammers on this game. Oh. He brought out the horse. Hey, I wonder where they got the idea to bring in a horse riding in from.
Final round. Your turn.
Oh, final round. No way I can win this one. I might as well just give up. But I got that extra move. They do all this nonsense to keep hooking you into the game. Yeah. I don't even have to say too much anymore. These games speak for themselves. Especially if they're pulling off stuff like fake player versus player. This is 2023. Real-time multiplayer should be a standard at this point. on mobile and on console. And PC. Look at this idiot taking 10 million turns. I'm not surprised if it's also a hacker in disguise. Yeah. Thankfully, there's no 3-star system in this. But that doesn't make the game any good. Just don't play this. Just don't play any Match 3 games. These are destroying my brain, so I'm gonna go to the next game before these rotting brains... That's not even a blooper! I don't even know what to say anymore! Fuck Match 3s! Let's try to clean our brains with the next game, which is not a guarantee. It's Level Maker. Another Mario Maker ripoff. Is Mario Maker 2 even relevant anymore? But let's go ahead and check out the Maker here. See, you can move around, up and down. You can pop, you can touch the screen to pop down blocks. Let's see what blocks they have. All the generic ripoff stuff. Pipes, thwumps. A dragon? Why does that dragon up there look different than the rest of the sprites? Such a contrast. Alright, let's check out the characters. I can guarantee you these are nothing more than cosmetics, like what the first Mario Maker pulled off. They had about 100 of those fucking things. This only has like 15. Yeah. Delete this level from my memory. Let's go ahead and play. Training Day. Well, this is a good example to see how the game plays. As you can imagine, there's no controller support, and the screen does not scroll incorrectly. Your character doesn't stay in the center. Oh god, that not Goomba just made me do a tongue twister. Okay. And yeah, the controller overlay is so big. Like, yeah, it's blocking the screen. It might be the right size for your thumbs. But is it the right size for the game's quality? I don't think so. And yeah, Big Goomba. Yeah. Yeah, whoever designed this level was real cute with the enemy sizes. Oh look, bees shooting down at you. I just got killed by a buzzsaw. Oh good, no checkpoints. Yeah. I'm getting PTSD from the original Mario Maker now. Thanks. Jerks. Now, let's just rush through this level. I don't care about the bees. What was that? Is that a Yoshi? No, I'm on a frog. I'm on a frog. Oh, never mind. This isn't Yoshi. At least I made it through the level. Challenge complete. Let's go back to the... Whoa-hoo! You just unlocked new blocks. Never mind. I want to go through another level. Two bridges, so I'm playing as someone different. You get a double jump. I forgot about the double jump. Yeah, this character doesn't do anything special. These are freaking cosmetics. Does that thing jump at the same time you do? That would be an interesting twist to see in a Mario game. Has that happened in a Mario game? I'm not sure. Or it could be thinking of Siobhan Action, where one enemy jumps at the same time you do. If they're taking inspiration for... Well, I fell off. Yeah. Let's try again. Ow, why'd I do that? Maybe it's just coincidence that the enemies are jumping at the same time as me. So let's get through this. Did that just glitch? Or did I just barely jump on it? No! Freak! One more time, I will beat this level. I will beat the game's terrible camera. And yes, cameras do exist in 2D games. Good. Nice glitch. Too bad you fall off if you don't keep holding right. Game over. Yeah, sanity over is more like it. This game tries to be Mario Maker 1 and fails. As if the original Mario Maker wasn't already a failure. Well, at least that game's done. But I still got two more. Oy vey. Let's go to the third game on our iOS library, Splat Toys. Yeah. Made in Unity. I suddenly have the urge to punch something. And this title screen has no music. And, oh look, development build. They put the wrong version of the game here. Let's try a Toy Gouda. Maybe an ink pistol, machine gun. Work in progress. Yeah, I'm convinced this is a beta version that accidentally made it out. Be the team that paints the biggest area. Yeah. 3, 2, 1. Hey, wait a minute! I thought I picked the Toy Gouda, not this reject fox. Oh well. You just move and shoot. It's a twin stick shooter. Rip off a Splatoon. No controller support because screw you. And you move so slow. Why do you move slow? In a game like this, you need to move faster. At least it could shoot the walls. Oh look, an enemy. Spraying purple. At least it's not pink. Can I kill him? Come on, kill him! Kill him! They have no friggin' life bar or anything. No indicator to tell you when you hit him. Oh wow, I died. That's not fair. They have no indication of whether they're getting hit. You could still camp at spawn. And the game won't give a crap. Yeah, come on, let me try to kill him. Come on. This game is more futile than life itself. Oh wow, now they have an indicator whether you're hitting them. What, was it a fluke the first time? Oh wow, I just got a double kill. Yeah, leave the foes to my fox friends. In before I make a joke about reflectors and shines and melee. Again, I'm trying to hit them, and it's not working. You can only kill them when they're further enough. This is supposed to resemble like a close range weapon, is it not? He's got a machine gun. And yeah, big problem with this one. It's too slow paced. You move as slow as a sloth. I bet a sloth could play this game better than I can. You can even move faster than the characters in this game. Look at this. It's awful. Who would want to play a sleep-inducing version of Splatoon for the mobile devices? Not me. If you're a Nintendo Switch owner, the choice is obvious. Oh look, we got 30 seconds left. I bet you they won't tell you who will win. There's gonna be, like, no fanfare. No soul in this. And I think I know the reason. This is a development build. Jeez. I know the butt of jokes of gaming right now is releasing half-finished games, but this is taking it a little too literal. Little literal. Alright, finish. Oh, it does have a percent screen. I win! No fanfare! Just go back to the title screen! Yeah. I bet this version wasn't supposed to get out, but someone screwed up and released it. Yeah. I bet you the finished product won't be much better, though. This is the definition of stale and boring. Well, I got one more game after this. I bet it won't be pretty. Trust me. Hey everyone, future editor G-Wizard here. Just want to give an advance warning that the following game coming up will have camera angles that I can only describe as nauseating. As such, especially if you have photosensitive epilepsy or are prone to seizures, I highly recommend proceeding with caution, because I value the viewing experience and your eyes more than these inept mobile game designers do. Without further ado, let's continue. Finally, we've reached the last game in the iPhone pile. Die Hard. Oy. Just what we need, another Splatoon wannabe. Yeah. It's the very definition of a dead giveaway. Splash shooter combat. And yeah, I named myself Inkling, because these developers can never catch me revealing the games they ripped off. Let's go for a quick game. Oh wow, you can actually put in bots. Since no one's playing this, let's put in 11 for a 6v6. That'll be even. The game crashed! Wow. I have never seen a game in the Free Factory do that, ever. Okay, let's try again. Die Hard, Splash Shooter Combat, Splatoon ripoff. My name is Inkling. Let's go for a quick game. Maybe we'll reduce the number of bots. Let's, wow, you can't take the zero off. That's stupid. Let's try 7. Let's do a clear 4v4. Maybe wait for it to load. Let's play. It crashed again. Is this game gonna flat out refuse to play for me? Like that Gang Nations game? Try reducing a number 5? Not even an odd number of players wants to... This is something else. This game just flat out refuses to play. Quick game, come on. Now it's taking 10 million years to load. Come on, connect, join room. Quickly enter bots. 3, 2v2. No, 5. Again, play. Shit! Alright, finally! I got it to work! I had to create a room! Oh wow, you move around. Oh my god. Wow. This is awful. The ammo meter is glitching. What? The ammo meter is glitching out. What is this? Oh god, the camera. I don't even know who I'm getting shot at. Oh god. The floor doesn't look right. It's glitching out. You can jump. But what was that? Who's shooting at me? Nothing's shooting at me. Is there an opponent in the distance? Oh god. Oh god, the game hurts to look at. The camera moves so bad. The frame rate is garbage. Garbage. I'm not kidding when I say this makes Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric on the Wii U seem to play at 120 frames per second. Oh god. Oh god. I think my vision is starting to completely die from playing this. Look at this. Look at this. Actually, don't. Because that's a bad idea. This guy isn't even doing... I'm gonna die. Okay. I didn't mean it literally. Oh, no. No. I can't with this game. I can't with this game. It's the amount of glitches isn't the problem. It's the performance. Oh. Die Hard. Yup, your site's gonna die playing this game. What were they thinking with this? The camera, when you move it, it's so hard on your eyes. I would rather play Pokemon Scarlet and Violet and put up with its performance issues than this. Ugh. I think I'm dying in more ways than two now. So, I'm just gonna end it quickly. So, that concludes Free Factory 37. Thank God. I think I'm gonna do a huge disservice by just saying, don't play these games. Hell, one of them can literally gouge your eyes out just by moving the camera in it. And we've also had a few others that stole character designs from Ninjala. And then some. Actually, no. Some wouldn't be enough to describe it. These games are still flooding the markets 8 years after I started the series. It just boggles the mind on what kind of quality control Apple and Google must have if they're letting these games slip through the cracks. Jesus, holiday. Insert holiday here. I've had enough. I'm gonna go away from these games for another few years, and I'm just gonna stick with what I do best. They're called consoles and handhelds. And maybe PC. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe for more content. Follow me on Twitter at ZeroFreezer. And I will see you guys in the next video. I'm once again reminded why mobile gaming can go suck a big one.